Hey everybody, in this tutorial we're going to talk about a couple of tips you can use when preparing for optimal head generation process in the headshot plugin for Character Creator 3. Okay, so a couple of tips and tricks I'll show you along the way just to get the best results possible in this plugin. Alright, so if you don't have your headshot plugin already loaded up, you can just find it in the Character Creator 3 toolbar up here. Just go to headshot right here. You can also find it under plugins and headshot right here and just load it up that way. I have mine on the toolbar as well, so right here. Okay. Let's go ahead and first take a look at a couple of tips for photo preparation. Okay, just click on this little link down here, and that's going to load up the help files in your Chrome or whatever browser you're using. And you can go here to photo for auto mode. Okay, there's a couple of important things to take a look at here. I'll explain them. You can read the text here on your own time. The image resolution doesn't matter in this case. 1K is the recommended resolution for auto. Because generally you're not going to have a high resolution texture for the auto-generated characters. Okay, so if you take a look at these images right here, there is even lighting. The lighting is soft, there's not too much harsh shadow on the characters' faces, or not too much harsh specular highlights on the characters' faces, and that's what you want. You want the character facing directly towards the camera with even lighting, and the lighting cannot be too high contrast like you see down here, okay? Or here they have like the shadows are too dark, and that's not good because it's not going to generate a very accurate result for your character's skin. Again, you also want to make sure that they are facing the camera with a neutral expression, very important. Make sure that their lips aren't too smiley or frowny, okay, facing forward. And, you know, part of the head can be covered by a fringe in this case, okay? So, for example, this character's hair is a little bit further down, and that's okay when you're in auto mode because it's going to generate an automatic hair. Okay, some things you want to avoid are things like fingers occluding the face, like in this example right here. You don't want to be showing your teeth or smiling, okay? Also, this face is not facing the camera here as well. Okay, so just make sure that you're following all these guidelines. They're pretty simple stuff. If you're familiar with Crazy Talk 8 or Cartoon Animator 4, you should be familiar with this stuff here. In Pro Mode, relatively the same thing, except in Pro Mode, you want to make sure that your resolution is 4K or higher. Okay, right here, resolution higher than 4K is recommended. Again, soft diffused lighting, front-facing character, front-facing head, neutral expression. You basically don't want to have this kind of stuff right here. Neutral expression again. Now the fringe here, again, recommended for auto mode, but not recommended for this mode because it's going to assume this is part of your character's forehead. And because it doesn't generate hair automatically, that's no good in Pro Mode. Okay? And you can take a look at the rest of that on your own time. Okay, let's take a look at the different ways you can load in your image to start off your head generation. The easiest way is just to go to load down here. And you can load your image that way. You can select it from here, and it'll load up in this section here. Another way you can do that is you can double-click on the template here and load it up that way. Okay, that's probably the easiest way, actually, is double-clicking it. Another thing you can do is you can click and drag it in from your Explore window. So if I have my Explore window open, I can simply just click and drag it in, whatever character I want, and it's going to appear, whatever face photo I want, it's going to appear right here in the Generate Character panel. We'll cancel this for now. And a really cool way, a new way that you can load up your image into the slot here is if you're in a photo editing software, it doesn't really matter what it is. I'm going to use Photoshop as this example here. Let's go ahead and use a selection, a rectangular selection tool here in Photoshop, and let's just crop this character's face. So generally it's recommended you just crop the character's face to, you know, so it only contains the face. You don't want too much of the body or the shoulders or anything like that. And this amount right here will be perfect. Okay. So what I'm going to do is just select that amount. I'm going to press Control C to copy. Okay. And then I'm going to go over to Alt Tab over to my project here. And there's a little button on the bottom right that allows you to paste. Okay. And I could paste it in there. And there it is. Okay. So what we're going to do first is we're going to load in a Pro version right now. So we have Pro selected here. And I'm going to keep the body type current, okay? There's different body types. There's male, female, neutral, and current, which is the one that we have on the screen right now, which is currently a female, okay? And there's different skin types. There's no mask. You can have different type of clean, soft skin, clean, rough. Okay, this will just cut, add a little more texture to your skin. You have a scalp on your character and a beard and scalp. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to use our current body type, and we're going to generate with a clean, soft skin type, okay? Let's go ahead and generate that. What that's going to do is that's going to load up our character's face. We're going to see the adjustment in just a moment. All right, and Shazam, after less than a minute, it's going to generate our character's face here. You can see the entire skin changes as well to the correct color. The tattoos and any decals you have on your character's skin will remain here, like this tattoo right here. Okay, and the original hair will remain as well. So we have this hair right here, and the character's face is just different. We're using this character's face template, smoothed out a little bit. But you can see a lot of the facial features are very similar. Of course, we'd have to adjust the eyes and the color of the eyes and the eye size and everything like that as well. But that's for another tutorial. Okay, so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to do the same thing, except I'm going to auto-generate. Okay, so with auto-generate, let's take a look at our character sliders first. So if we go to our sliders, because I wanted to emphasize here that when you have sliders on your character, that are modified, like the full body sliders right here. For example, if we take these and we adjust any of the sliders, we just go to currently used. None of them are currently used right now, but if we, you know, adjusted maybe our body tone, for example, you're more like a bodybuilder type, whatever, we can even do individual adjustments like this to whatever we want. And then you can see currently used. We're using these ones right here. Okay, now when we generate, whether using auto or pro, we'll go ahead and switch to auto here. And when we switch to auto and we generate using auto, we're going to use the same current body type and clean soft here. It's going to reset the sliders. Okay, so just be aware whenever you do this, it'll reset the sliders on your current project. Okay, so we'll go ahead and generate using auto again. And this is going to generate automatically generated hair as well as the same face. Okay, so now when this is generated, you can see that our currently used sliders go back down to zero. There's no currently used morph sliders, and it resets everything. Okay, so just keep that in mind. And you can see we have the automatically generated hair. In this case, it's pretty decent. Again, good enough for an NPC character or some character off in the distance. And the face texture is, you know, relatively similar. If you don't want to have the morph gizmo, by the way, interfering with all of your beautiful facial features here, you can turn the morph gizmo off by clicking this up here, toggling the morph gizmo on and off, and then it won't show up yellow highlights when you mouse over your character's face. Okay, let's try one more thing here. I'm going to auto-generate another one, and I'm going to show you a male character with beard and scalp, okay? So let's go ahead and just double-click on the image, and we're going to select this male character here now, this dude right here. We won't use the current body type. We're going to change the body type to male, okay? And then we're going to change the skin type to beard and scalp. Okay, so it's going to create a kind of a scalp on the character and a beard as well. This is, keep in mind, this is automatically generated. Okay, so we'll go ahead and do that and generate one more time. Okay, and what we'll have here is we'll have an automatically generated beard. Now, this is not the beard generated from the picture. This is a beard that we've generated automatically. You can see if we zoom in, we get some nice detailed beard kind of strands on our character's face, and we have that automatically generated hair as well, okay? And again, it's supposed to be viewed sort of from like a distance or something like that, so automatically generated NPC should look something like this. And we've, generated a male body here as well, okay? So again, male body type with beard and scalp, and I showed you the beard as well. Let's take a look at female as well. Okay, so if we have a male character on the screen, we want to switch it to a female character. Again, same process. I'm just going to double click on the image here, and I'm going to load up the same female image here. We'll use female, and this time we'll use clean soft again and generate that. And it's going to swap out for a female character's body with essentially the same kind of stuff we saw earlier. Okay, so again, it swapped us out for a female body here. And if we zoom out, you can see we have the female body with the lingerie and everything, and the same automatically generated hair and face, again, that can be tweaked as much as you want later on. Now, the last thing I'm going to take a look at is the neutral body type, okay? So if I go ahead and load in a different character, let's load in a child character, okay? So this little kid picture right here, okay? Now, for this kid, I'm going to go ahead and use a neutral body type, all right? And we're going to go ahead and choose clean soft for this one, okay? So similar to the female because, you know, it doesn't have a lot of wrinkles on his face because he's still a kid. And then we'll go ahead and generate this. All right, so once that's finished processing, essentially what you'll get is what you see on the screen here, a fairly androgynous looking character, a very neutral body type. Now I've added boxer shorts onto the character to conform with YouTube policy here. Just so you're aware, your character will generally be nude. Okay, so this is basically what we start with here. And you can use the advantage of having a neutral body type is that it's not influenced by any morph sliders initially. So it'll be completely neutral, and you can start from there and kind of develop it into whatever you want. So say, for example, if I wanted to add more more of a childlike look, I can go down to my morphs here, and under like full body, I'll just type in Luna. There's a baby Luna here from Hivewire. You can purchase this from the content store. I'll zoom out a little bit because he's going to get a little bit shorter here, and we'll just take that down, and you can see we can really reduce the age appearance of this character quite a bit, and we can as well activate our morph gizmo here, and make the arms a little bit skinnier, forearms a little bit skinnier and stuff. We can make the legs thinner and the neck, and just make everything shorter as well. Various ways that you can adjust your character to make it look appear a little bit younger. And the neutral body type is a great starting point for that. I'm going to give you another example of a neutral body type here. So let's go back to our headshot tab here, and in auto, we'll double click on the image, and we're going to load in this time a female character, a bit of a heavy set female character. We're going to use the neutral body type again, and clean and soft for the face. And I'll just go ahead and generate this. Okay. So again, the result you're going to get is very neutral androgynous type character body. Just like this. Okay, we've put some underwear on this character again to conform with YouTube policy. And I can go over to things like my sliders here. Let's go back to a full body slider right here. And we can increase body size to make our character a little bit chubbier. Maybe something like this. And we can go down and find a base CC3 base female, for example, and give our character some more female shape. We rotate to the side. You can see maybe a bit better there. And again, we can use the morph to further increase the size on things like the stomach, for example. Let's put our character into a different pose really quickly here. Female, let's just use something like this here. Okay, we can take that stomach out a little bit, to just emphasize, certain traits of our character. And we may want to adjust, just like that. And again, these sliders can all be adjusted as you wish. Okay, so that's really about all there is to it, guys. Thanks so much for watching here. Make sure you check out our forums over at forum.reillusion.com. I just want to show you a couple of tips here for starting off your head creation process in the headshot plugin. And so again, hopefully you learned a lot, and I hope to see you in the next video.